Hello guys, welcome back to another episode of Feed the Beast. This is Algorythm44, and it's been a very long time since I've got a chance to record. I made a village, moved all my stuff underneath, and, let me start off by saying the reason I haven't got to record is because, the first week I had finals. And I was just studying the entire time and I couldn't record any. And then for 2 weeks, I had to go to a stupid family reunion, and I'll talk about that. And then this week that I'm back, my parents have just been bugging the crap out of me, so I can't record when they're like, do this, every 5 minutes. Alright, first off, I'll go through my inventory. I don't even remember what I had, but I got Fortune 3 and a diamond drill, a chainsaw, which I'm using as a sword, advanced jetpack, and helmet. What I'm trying to do is get one of each protection on the armor. I'm gonna get projectile for the helmet and blast for the boots. It doesn't matter which you put it on, but the best thing to do is not all protection 4. It used to be, but now that the other protections got buffed, it's better to have one of each. I got some tanks. This one's lithium, hydrogen, sodium, silicon. And those two are empty. Okay. I recently just moved down here, so I just put all the chests right here, and then I'm still moving stuff into barrels and all that. I got Merlin, the Enchanter, right there. Inside this, the top section right here, it's just a 2-block-high space, or 3x3x2, and there's melee turtles. That one looks like he's stuck or something. But, and those guys are killing wither skeletons, which is this. I have this turtle. Oh, let me explain. The turtles kill and put stuff into the relays, which then go into these barrels. This is fully repaired stone swords. If they have nowhere to go, they go into this restriction pipe, and then into this barrel. And then this turtle takes two things out, it doesn't matter what they are, tries to craft them together, and then puts them into the relay. And then either the sword will be full and go into there, or it won't be full and it'll come back around to get repaired again. I might show the code for that later, it's really simple. And then there's a witch spawner about, I think, ground level here. It's just a 3x3 shaft straight down, like 40 blocks or so. And they just die to fall damage, and then all their stuff comes up here. This, I have, this turtle, this is Alfred, and his ender chest. And I made a excavate command, like my own version. It's a lot better than the standard one that comes with the turtle. And he will put stuff in the ender chest, and this turtle will take it out and just put it into these chests. This turtle, you give him iron, he places it there, breaks it, and then puts it in here. And this is a 3x3x3 nether brick thing with the middle and this taken out, and that effectively makes a wrath oven, or wraith, however you want to pronounce it, and you just light it in the middle, and then it goes out after a certain number of blocks, but there's no time limit on it. At least I don't think. This, I made a industrial blast furnace and the casing. It's sunk in the ground one. This is actually the thing Builder built. I haven't taken it out because I don't know if he's coming back or not. This is a mushroom spawner. They fall into... can't really see it. You can kind of see it there. They fall into lava and burn, and then you get steak and leather. And then I'm going to tie this to a sugarcane farm, which will put sugarcane in here. And then I'm going to have this turtle underneath his barrel, taking the sugarcane, making it into paper, and then taking a piece of leather out and making a book. So that'll be a complete book farm right there. Right now he's out because just messing up a little bit, so I didn't want him throwing out all my leather. This is a scrap box system. This is a 1x2x4, which I guess if you count the water it's more than that, but whatever, it's 1x2x4. This turtle takes water from underneath, puts it into the water mill. The water mill gives power to the recycler. The recycler gets cobble from the extruder. Why? You not working? Oh. one of these cows must have gotten underneath the... give me that. He must have gotten underneath and then milked him. Oh, that's hilarious. See if any more are like that. No? Okay. I was wondering why that was empty and that's not. And then this turtle, he gets stuff into... he's a crafting turtle, yes. And he puts stuff in that 9x9 grid, crafts it, and puts it in the barrel. And then I just have 4 of those. I can keep expanding as long as I want, but that's good enough. I also have river bees that I traded with someone to make clay combs, to get clay dust, to centrifuge into sodium, lithium, silicon, and something else I don't remember. I also have the methane or methane, whatever you want to call it, being electrolyzed into hydrogen to put into that tank over there. This is still a mess. This is all going to change, especially this. I hate all this. All these crates. Oh yeah, I added a monitor to Merlin so that he will display the level here instead of me having to check it. And then above him I just put a relay and a pipe and then a chest. I could have him just place forward, but I didn't feel like changing that. What else? Hold on, I'm trying to think. Oh yeah, I made a safe instead of using the ender chest, even though it was safe. Well, the ender chest was... I don't want to say safe, because this is a safe. Other people couldn't take from it. How about that? And then I got this. Well, this is all the stuff in my safe, which... I'm working on a zombie Pikmin shard. Let's see, what else? Okay. Oh yeah, all these villagers in that village have crappy trades. So I'm probably going to change them out for the one in there. Guy on the last server I played on, Blackjack, he's moved on to this server. He still hasn't found out why the past server has crashed. But, I don't know. Forgot what I was going to say. I kind of don't want to work on that guy. I guess I can show you this guy. And there's one other Oh yeah, I'll show you the, whoops, can't think and type. I'll show you the Wrath Turtle next. Pretty much just, well, I have to sleep in there so it doesn't like spam the crap out of the server. Pulls two items, crafts it, and then puts it above him. So, super simple program. And that, like, even if something goes in there that shouldn't go in there, it still should get sorted out. Like, if a piece of coal, like, this happens sometimes. If you have two pieces of coal, one goes in, and the other tries to go in while this is updating, then it'll say, oh, crap, I can't go in there, and then keep going. So even if a piece of coal got into this chest, it would just try and craft it, it wouldn't work, and then it would put it in the relay, and then it would come back to this. Which, then he might, if it gets into the second spot, that might be a problem, but that hasn't happened yet. Oh yeah, the Wraith Turtle. I actually wrote this once, and it was working, and then I wrote it for Ralphie, and it wasn't working at his base for some reason. And then I just made a new one, and it was better. So I replaced it, and I got this. So he waits until there's an item in this first slot. And then for that, the number of items is stored in A. And then for every block of iron, he puts it down, waits till it turns to dark iron, and then picks it back up. And then all of the dark iron will be in slot 2. Like if he only has one item, then it won't be in slot 2, it'll be in slot 1, so that's why I have this if statement. And then he just puts it in the chest above him, and then goes back to slot 1. So that's another really simple program. And then, I guess I could show the crafting turtles. I don't remember if I did show it or not. I haven't recorded in so long. Alright, so, once again, so it doesn't spam the server. Reset A, which is the slot position. So this is slot 1, 2, 3, 4, then it goes to the next row, 5, 6, 7, 8. So what this does is it keeps on sucking until it gets something in that slot, and then it moves to the next one. But if it gets to slot 4, this one, slot 8, or slot 12, it skips it, because you can't have anything there. This is the crafting table, pretty much. And then this is pretty much just saying if it's greater than 1, then continue with the loop. And then just go down here. Whenever you craft something, it will go to the slot that's selected. So I need to move the crafting slot to one of these. I just put it to 16. So it goes down here, and then crafts it, puts it in the barrel below, and then goes starts over. So that's that. Which I can show you. There's still a ton of scrap in this one. So let's say it picks up one from the recycler, goes to the next spot, skips this one, goes to the next spot, goes to the next spot, and then crafts, and then puts in the barrel, and then goes back to 1. So, pretty simple program. And it doesn't matter if it picks up like 5 there, it'll pick up one, pick up one, pick up one, and then this one's full, so it'll craft it straight away. See? And then what I've been doing is just taking them out and then unloading them all on this, and all the crap goes in here. Ton of dusts. I need to actually sort through those later. What else is there? Excavate command. So, I just called it excavate 2 because I couldn't think of anything. Alright, so this is better in that it's, you can configure it with X, Y, and Z. The X I have is -1 because it was like messing up. Like, this is what you have if you want to type in a number, like, you know, the regular excavate command, you type excavate and then a number, and that number is the size. Well, this is what mine does. T is the turn. Well, I'll get to that later. Z is the height, and the width and the length. It goes to slot 15, which you put the ender chest here and a piece of stone here, and then it will dig anything that is not stone. I guess you could put anything here, but stone is the best. Is compare above it and compare below it. What it does is it goes every 2. So say this is like a slice of the world, and these are the different Y levels. It would go across, checking above and below, the line above and the line below. And then when it gets to the other end, it will come down by 2, and then dig out this row and check above and below. So this row gets checked because it's underneath this one, and then this row gets checked because it's above, or I don't even know which one I'm talking about anymore, but it checks below and above. So it's kind of like when you're branch mining, you leave a 2-wide gap, except this is on its side. And then if there's, when it digs, it puts it in slot 1 until that fills up, and then it just keeps filling. So when it gets to slot 14, because these two are already full, when it gets to slot 14, it will place down the, or it'll dig out a space in front of it, it'll place down the ender chest, and then put all 14 slots into the ender chest, and then it will pick up the ender chest again, and then carry on with the duties. Oh, hold on, there's more. This is the turn for each row. Like, say this is a top-down view. He goes this way, and he has to turn right and come back, and then he has to turn left, and then go back up, and then turn right, and then turn left. So it alternates between right and left, and that's pretty much what this is. If it's true, do the turning right and set it to false, and then the next time it comes around, it will be false and do the turning left and make it so it turns right the next time. And then between levels, it goes down 3. So this is like, it dug here, and it checked this row as it was going down here. And then it digs down 3, and then it checks this row as it's digging out this row. I don't even remember what that's for. And then after it's done, it will come up, it'll pretty much just drill its way to the surface, so I don't have to go find it. And that's that. That took a lot longer to explain than I thought it would. This one's just suck down, place forward, or drop forward. Never do place, because if he has a block and he places it, it will delete this block. So it's drop whenever you want to place something into an inventory. There's a timer. I guess I'm fully caught up. Next episode, I'll tell you about the freaking family reunion. And yeah, I'll end it here. Okay, I'll see you guys next time. Bye-bye.